Buried while alive is, beyond question, the most terrific of these extremes which has ever fallen to the lot of mere mortality.
My word. What was that? Some manner of specter seems to have crossed our path. Perhaps the crash has done a number on my eyes. Regardless, I don't believe we'll be traveling by coach anytime soon. We'll have to venture forth on foot. Fortunately, the town is not far off. Let's clear this tree from the road and be on our way. Patron, Julien, lives in the town ahead, just beyond the ridge. A man of low means and fond of literature, he fell in love with a woman of high society named Victorine Lafourcade. Madame Lafourcade reciprocated Julien's feelings, but due to her societal status, she was married to a wealthy banker whom she did not love. Look out. You weren't hurt, were you? Something is going on upstairs. Once again, the specter appears before us. I do not understand whether she means to help us or...
Go away. Please. Don't come any closer. Don't try and stop me. I no longer wish to live.
Please, my friend, try and calm down. We've come at your request to investigate the death of Madame Victorine Lafourcade. Why don't you give me the rope and let's the three of us talk, shall we?
No. What have I to talk about? My beloved Victorine promised to write me not long ago, but then she suddenly passed away. And her letter never... I am... beyond destroyed, and I never got a chance to say goodbye.
I am truly sorry for your loss, Monsieur Julien. But before you do anything rash, please, give me and my associate a chance to find Victorine's letter. Perhaps it will bring you some peace. We'll be back very soon.
Detective, please...
Thank you.
Oh, Detective, I am without words. You don't know what finding Victorine's letter means to me. Her letter says she still loves me, and that her husband's temperance has been changing as of late. I cannot, Detective, I implore you to discover the conditions of Victorine's death, and to find where she's been. I've tried to do this myself, but every time I would visit the fort, they do not think me a societal equal to them, so they owe me no explanation. Without your help, I fear there will be no resolution to this matter, and Victorine will never rest peacefully.
Fear not, Monsieur Julien. My associate and I do not make a habit of giving up on investigations. We will discover the truth for you. Now, if you please, give us the rope and promise us that you'll wait for our return without doing something you'll regret.
Yes, I promise, Detective. If I may, I suggest you begin your search at the cemetery and speak with the ground. When you discover where she's been buried, please come and let me know. Welcome back, detectives. Have you been...
Greetings, my good man. I am Detective Dupin, and this is my associate. Would you be so kind as to allow us to search the cemetery grounds?
I'm afraid I must ask you to come back tomorrow. It is too late, and I've a good... Now, should you bring me some water so that I could wash the windows of the hut, then perhaps we could make an arrangement. Welcome back to...
Here you are, sir. Just as you requested.
Thank you, my friends. You've scratched my back, so now I will scratch yours and let you into the cemetery. May I ask why you wish to search the ground?
We were hired to look into the death and burial of a loved one. She passed away just recently.
I see. I seem to recall a young woman being buried. The gravediggers told me that her husband was very generous and paid them extra to complete the burial quick. I assume he was overwhelmed with grief and wanted to put it all behind him.
Do you happen to remember the name of the man who paid your gravediggers?
Let's see. Raoul? Rene, was it? No. Renel. Yes, it was Renel. I believe his is also a member of the city council, now that I think on it. This wasn't the first time he was here. Monsieur Foray's previous wife passed away a few years ago, who was also buried in hate.
Thank you.
Welcome back, detectives.
Thank you. Truth, as I knew you would. In life, I had a condition in which I would fall into a deep death. My husband, Renel, knew this and let them bury me alive, as he was after my family's money. Now, in death, I want nothing more than revenge, and I will have it.
Thank you.
Sir, I feel I should tell you that Louise Foray, Renelle's first wife, was not dead when she was buried.
Heavens, how could such a thing be true? I remember Madame Foray's funeral some years ago. I always thought it strange that a man of means like Monsieur Foray would have such a quiet and discreet funeral, much like the most recent one for Victorine.
I should say that there is an obvious link between the two deaths, Victorine's and Louise's. They were both married to Monsieur Foray and died relatively shortly after being married. Then he buries them both with little to no public presence. I believe at this point it is prudent to investigate Monsieur Foray. We must discern his motive for killing his wives and find irrefutable evidence of his guilt.
Thank you.
Welcome back, detectives. Have you been able to learn where Victorine was buried?
all this is over, four shall die.
Thank you. Well, if it isn't the little detective duo. I've heard of you both. Don't think I didn't know you'd come for me. Too bad for you that Louise's spirit beat you to it. Louise may think she has won, but I will laugh last. You've not won. Victorine is...
No, Monsieur Foray. What about Victorine? Is she still alive? Renel was gloating, because he's known all along that Victorine is still alive. Wait, what is that in his hand?
Thank you, my friends. You have proven Renel's guilt, and I can now rest peacefully. Renel will no longer be able to prey upon others simply to satisfy his own greed.
We haven't a minute to waste. We must find the remaining piece to the key of Victorine's crypt and find her while there's still a chance she yet lives. It must be somewhere here in the house.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
I do think now would be a good time to check in on poor Julien. Julien, there is a chance that Victorine is still alive. Monsieur Foray triggered her deep sleep condition and proceeded to bury her alive so that he could claim her wealth. We must hurry to the cemetery and find her crypt, and hope we are not too late.
Oh, thank you. Thank you both. Yes, I will come with you. Let us go, right now.
We should speak again with the groundskeeper when we arrive.
Oh, detectives! How goes the investigation?
We've learned that Victorine Lafourcade was buried alive. We have a clue that might help. Have you seen this before?
Where did you get this, detectives? Normally, only the relatives of the deceased are in possession of...
Please, sir. This key is keeping a living woman locked in a place reserved for the dead. You have to help us save her.
The main entrance to the old part of the cemetery was walled over years ago. But there is a way in. Find it, and you'll have your way in.
Thank you.
I fear brute strength will not work here, but rest assured, we'll find a way. My friend and I will find a way to get inside the crypt. Julien, please, remain here with Victorine.
Surely, Detective. I will stay here with Victorine. But please, hurry. Don't worry, my dear. I'm here with you. The detectives will save you, dearest. Of that, I am sure. Just be patient a little while longer. Please, hurry, Monsieur Dupin.
Detectives! Wait, there is another door here in the crypt that leads to a tunnel out, but I cannot open it from this side. Take this key and find...
Thank you.
finally, you are safe, and the villain Renal has paid for his crimes, and we can be together.
And since Renal was never able to steal my money, we'll be able to live comfortably for the rest of our lives together.
Victorine, my love, I know I am but a poor man, but will you marry me?
Yes, of course I will marry you, Julien.